Hey, my name is Ilya Satouri, 24 years old, Zerg player for Team Gamers Origin, and I've been playing StarCraft 2 for 6-7 years right now.
When did you start playing
Oh my god. I always had like a thing for RTS since I'm very young, so I started with the Red Alert and Age of Empire, but not that much because I didn't have my own computer. Then it went on Warcraft 3 from 13 to 16 and a half, 17 maybe. And I really had high hopes on Warcraft 3 to be professional, but sadly, like the game was almost ending as StarCraft 2 was starting. And I was still in high school, so I couldn't really put the time I wanted into it. And yeah, StarCraft 2 going out was like the perfect moment for me because I just had finished high school, or we went out like maybe 1 year into my last year of high school. And after that, I could just completely focus on it. It's less about the tournaments itself, it's more about the reputation of the players. Like, I wasn't actually watching tournaments. Back then, I don't think there was streams, live streams of tournaments. I don't know if there was or not, but I never saw one. I just know, like, players by reputation, and I was just, like, mostly watching replays. So I didn't even know, like, physically the players, what they looked like. It's just, like, I was watching the replays and seeing how they played, and I was like, this is wonderful. I wish I could do such moves. I wish I could, like, think like them into, like, strategically thinking about like what's your next move and stuff like that, and yeah, it really made me into RTS. Korea doesn't really fit me. Like, on the long term, I don't feel like I belong in Korea. Like, the gamer house or gaming house is about practicing all day, and there's not a lot of activities or a lot of things going on. And staying behind the computer, I can do that for 3 weeks, but after that, it just gets a bit depressing, I think. Well, at least here we have like a foreigner team house. Like, the past times I came to Korea, it was mostly Korean, so like I couldn't even discuss with people and have a bit of a talk here and there. Right now, it's like a bit more fun since like it's mostly foreigners, only one Korean. So like we're still having a good time, but it's not like sustainable on the long term. My goals have always been to just be the best, or try to like, it's less about, right, there's the money in it, and the money was a big part in the start. Right now, it's not completely about the money. It's more about being respected for what you deliver and beating the opponent. Like, the game itself doesn't really give any pleasure, I think. Like, if you do a good move, or if you do, like, you kill a lot of units with a bending and stuff. Like, I actually, when you see my face in a game, there's nothing going on. I get the pleasure from really the victory at the end, and seeing that you're being respected for what you've done. Like, you never know if you're gonna be performing, you never know about the next balance patch, you never know about like the next meta, what it's gonna be, if it's gonna fit your style or not. And I feel like that's the hardest part. Like, practicing is very simple and easy. It's like something I love to do, and I don't really have to put effort into it, but like adapting to all the things you can't really control is very frustrating. I really love the community we have, but maybe it's not the case for everybody. Some people say like they complain a lot, or they expect too much, or they're never satisfied. Like, for myself, from my point of view, I always felt like the community was constantly supporting me, and they were really wishing me the best. And even in hard times, they were trying to comfort me and trying to make me feel better about it, and less focused on the defeats and try to see the longer run. And right now, I feel like we have an inner core, like a very strong core of like fans, a fan base which is very solid and is not about to leave the scene anytime soon. Like, everybody keeps saying like StarCraft 2 is dying, but I think it's like quite stable right now, if not like slightly expanding since the free to play. And you have to be really kind of hardcore about the game, I think, to be able to appreciate it. And that's what makes the access to a new public really hard for this game. So I feel like you don't get a lot of like random people being able to add their negativity to the community. Like, most of the people who actually speak about the game usually watch it a lot and are able to speak about it, I think. But that's like very general, there's always like cancer people everywhere. But mostly I feel like we have a good one. I didn't expect it that early. Like, I really wanted to be a pro gamer, but I didn't think I would be the best that quickly. And I don't know, like, I feel like I've done it at a time where it was a bit too easy to truly appreciate the status of it. But nowadays, I feel like being the best in StarCraft 2, like, there's no one best player in StarCraft 2 right now. It's always like a constant fight for the first place, and like every single tournament you don't see the same person winning now. And I feel like that's something which shouldn't happen anymore nowadays. Like, and it's even better like this, like not having like one single best person, like everybody's actually fighting for the title. If I compare my level that I had back then to the level I have right now, I'm 100 times way better than I used to be. Like, back then the game was so simple. I'm not speaking about the strategy itself, it's just like a player's ability to be able to control the game from early to the end of it was very, very simple. The game was extremely slow. Like, the speed didn't really change, but like the interaction with units or the harassment possibilities were way, way lesser back then. So once you defended something, you knew like you were like free for 3 minutes or something. So it was less stressful. And when I look at myself now, like, I see like I'm not the best anymore, obviously. But when I compare my level, like, I see like there's a huge improvement. And I see that there's a lot I can still learn. And that's what it's about. Like, being the best is about learning the most. And so if I can still learn, it means like I can still improve, right? I don't know if I'll be able to like combine school and StarCraft again for the third year. Second year is possible, like I actually have a lot of free time and I'm able to do it. For the third year it's going to be maybe harder, maybe not. Like, I need to be able to judge like the first or 2 months. I will be like focusing on the studies. If I see it's going well, I might try to play a bit more StarCraft too. But I don't have a necessity right now to play. Like, I feel like I achieved what I wanted to achieve. If I can just like keep playing on my free time, I will. But eventually the goal is to get a job, I think, like not end up my life as a gamer. I always felt like the way I'm playing is the way that the game is supposed to be played. Even though like I know it's completely wrong, but I can't really correct that. So like I'm never looking at players and being like, wow, this guy is a god. And I don't have an idol. Like, I used to have that on Warcraft 3, but StarCraft 2, it was impossible for me to be here. Even at my start, like, I didn't know anyone from Brood War. Like, everybody was, like, amazed by Jadong and stuff when they came to SE2. I like myself. Yeah, so thanks a lot for supporting me, guys. It was a pleasure. It is a pleasure to always compete and see that you're supporting me, loving what I try to show in the games. And thanks for sticking with us. I think we can have marvelous years going on for... Yeah. Yeah. That was a bad end, though.
I liked it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. If you want to redo it.
That was a hesitation, but it's okay. Let's leave it like that.